And welcome to Pandatech, the best channel on VPN tools and online security hacks. Today we'll talk about one of the greatest features VPN providers have, why you should use it, and why you should choose VPN providers that have these features. I'm talking about kill switch here. Straight into the topic, what is a kill switch? Kill switch is a security feature that protects your IP in case you unexpectedly lose your connection to VPN server. In case your connection is interrupted, kill switch will automatically block all external traffic to and from your IP address until it automatically re-establishes connection to the same VPN server. That means that even if you can't use your internet while you're reconnecting to your VPN server, your IP address and your DNS queries will be safe from being exposed. If you're really, really keen on being safe on the web, this is a must-have feature. Some VPNs often have this feature activated by default, but you can deactivate it if you want, which I strongly recommend that you don't do, and I'll explain later why. So let me actually show you how this feature looks like in different VPN solutions and where you can find it. Let me go here. Now let's start with NordVPN. To find kill switch feature, you go to settings menu, and here it is, right here, kill switch. And here you have two options. You can either activate it like for good, like disable the entire internet access when not connected to VPN, or you can activate an app kill switch when you turn on this kill switch feature and then you add apps on which these will work. For example, say I want to add a browser, a certain browser, to my apps list. For example, say I want to pick a Brave browser as my safest browser. And here is where you can choose apps that will use this kill switch feature and thus protect you on the web. So let me show you some other VPN providers later on. Now, how does kill switch work? A VPN kill switch works by constantly monitoring your connection, detecting issues, blocking your access to internet, and restoring your connection as soon as it is safe. Now, here is a more detailed breakdown on how a VPN kill switch feature works. A VPN kill switch continuously monitors your connection to your VPN server by scanning for changes in status or IP address. The second is detecting. VPN kill switch will instantly detect any changes that could prevent your VPN from working properly. Then comes blocking. Depending on what type of VPN you're using, your VPN kill switch will either block certain apps or your entire device from accessing the internet. And then comes restoring. As soon as the issue is resolved, your VPN kill switch will restore your internet connection without you having to do anything. Now again, when does VPN kill switch activate? VPN kill switch activates as soon as it detects that something has gone wrong with your connection to your VPN server. For example, when your internet connection is disconnected from your VPN server because you experience some connectivity issues, or when you say decide to switch your VPN servers, or important, if you use some unreliable network connections, such as say public Wi-Fi's. Another one can be if your computer say does an update overnight and then reconnects to your internet without connecting to your VPN server. Or say if you start using a new firewall that blocks your VPN and you forgot to add an exception for your VPN. Or if someone starts using your device without restarting your VPN first. Now let's switch to Surfshark here. And to activate kill switch, you should go to settings menu. Here it is. And go to the connectivity tab, and here you can find kill switch. It doesn't really provide you options on whether to activate kill switch on a certain app or the entire internet. It actually disables the entire internet access when VPN connection drops or is turned off. So you can turn on this feature in Surfshark here. Now, an important question: why you should use VPN kill switch? Well, VPN kill switch is basically your last line of defense, and it makes sure that your IP address is never uncovered. It also makes sure that nobody has an access to your unencrypted data when your VPN connection goes down. Now, another important question, and that is, who should use a VPN kill switch, because while an occasional drop in connectivity will not be the end of the world for most people, there are certain groups of people who should be protected at all times and should care about their VPN connection at all times. And the first one is those who love using public Wi-Fis. Once your unencrypted data is revealed, anybody around you will have an access to it. The second group is activists and journalists who don't want to be tracked down. Another one is users of peer-to-peer transfer software who need to mask their IP addresses. That's where the next comes from, and that is torrent users who want to stay anonymous. And finally, anyone holding confidential documents who can't afford to have their security compromised, such as lawyers or social workers handling incredibly sensitive data. By the way, for which purpose are you using VPN? Let me know in the comments if this is not something illegal. Okay, so let's go to ExpressVPN, and here you go to Settings menu, to Options, and here they don't really have this feature named kill switch, they call it Network Lock, which also stops all internet traffic if VPN disconnects unexpectedly, and it also allows the access to device on the local network, so you can choose either both or one of them or none of them. So this is how it works for ExpressVPN. And I'll leave the links to the VPNs I'm currently using in the description box below, make sure to check them out. With that said, I hope you liked this episode. If you did, make sure to give me a huge like, subscribe and hit the notification bell for more upcoming episodes on online security hacks and VPN tutorials. And I will be waiting for you in our next episode. I'll be waiting. You'd better come.